All right, this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. We're here in California, nice sunny January, mid-January day, and I'm here with Mama. Say hi, Mama. Mama's a little foster dog. She's available for adoption. And but we're here in the garden, and we're going to talk about the garden today while Mama follows me around. And I'm happy to announce that we got the full front yard planted out for the winter season finally after being already mid-January. So I want to go over what we planted and what's going on. So everything, as you can see, is all edible in one form or another, and we planted different areas based on kind of different things. So right in the front here, I wanted to have some nice color, and so we planted violets or violas. And the violas are edible flowers, so I love to eat the violas. They're my favorite edible flower to eat. To me, they taste like a candy, but without the sweetness. So actually, if you have some viola, maybe like a bite of an apple, I mean, that's a pretty amazing combination. Then, so that's like the first row here, and then it goes down the side here. So it brings some nice color. You can kind of see in this next bed, really looks brilliant. So I could, you know, literally just go down and pick one flower off each plant and put that on top of a salad if I'm bringing it to a potluck or just eating at home. Looks really nice, and you know, you definitely were eating the rainbow when we're eating viola flowers. They're, you know, nice, deep, rich purple color, and you know, there's even some yellow in there and white. And they're my favorite. You should try to grow them. They'll overwinter here in California. I'm in Northern California, so it may get barely into freezing temperature sometimes. So the next row behind that, we actually planted mache. And so mache or mosh, second row. And then behind that, we planted a row of bok choy. So this is a mixed bed here. And behind that, we have a broccoli growing. So hopefully, you know, these are kind of smaller. They get taller, then they get taller with the broccoli. And then in the back, we have a row of mixed colored chard. So we have a red, green, and yellow chard. And over in this area that looks like there's nothing planted out, we actually seeded wild arugula. So there's, you know, two different varieties of arugula. There's wild arugula and then regular arugula. This is the wild arugula. And I was told that the wild arugula can be perennial and continue to grow if you just keep picking off the leaves and picking off the flower buds. And the regular arugula hasn't really worked like that for me, so we'll see what happens. Under the fig tree, we're utilizing the space underneath the fig tree now in the wintertime, because underneath the summertime it's pretty much useless because the fig leaves shaded out. But underneath the fig tree in wintertime, definitely get some good sun, as you can see. And those are just basically a total mix greens and some other extra things we had hanging out. We had started all those in the greenhouse. Probably some of my favorites in there are the, I think white kale, white winter kale, Siberian kale, Siberian white kale, I believe. And just a whole bunch of different things we had started. So we'll see how those do. Then in the back of this big bed here, we have the fava beans. So I did another episode on the fava beans. So this is basically all the cover crop. This is where the heavy feeders or the tomatoes were last season, so we're gonna do that with fava beans. Let's go ahead and move over to the front bed now. So the front bed is progressing pretty nicely here, and you know, once again we have the violas in the front, and then we have a section, you know, about three quarters of the bed, or two-thirds of the bed one-third of the bed of spinach. So these are nice rows of spinach here. And then the next, we have the arugula. Just this is now regular arugula, not the wild arugula, growing. And then followed by the bok choys here, growing pretty nice. The next bed, actually, we have all lettuce growing. And the lettuce was growing, but it just wasn't growing fast enough because it was probably not warm enough for the lettuce to do optimally. So we, you know, used the PVC hoops that we made, and we made row covers. And how we did this is, we just used some plastic sheeting, and we did a basically a 1-inch PVC pipe that's 15 feet long. And I guess it did rain last night, so there's some water collected, and we'll try to drain that out here. Basically, what we're gonna try to do here is roll up the PVC now. We're gonna, as you can kind of see, I'm trying to do this with two hands. We're rolling up. Okay, so we basically, wow, man, it's really warm in there. That's amazing. It's significantly warmer when I rolled up this this piping here. So okay, so now we got it rolled up. Let me get the clip here. All right, so as you can see, we basically just rolled it up, and so now in the daytime, the goal is to let it get some sun and some good air, and maybe I think the soil is still pretty wet. But man, it's significantly warmer in here, and you know, let me tell you, it's only been a week since we put this on, the lettuce is growing significantly better than it was before we put the plastic on it. So definitely recommend doing that. This next bed is doing wonderfully without any plastic. And basically it's a mixture of brassicas. So we have, you know, collard greens, flash collards, red boar kale. And my favorite is the red Russian kale. Actually, that's my second favorite. The super favorite is the Siberian kale. And we have some other broccolis and other things mixed in there. So all the leaves in that bed are all edible. So even broccoli leaves and everything, they look like kale. They taste pretty much like kale. You know, just use them as other brassicas. I like to eat all the, leaves raw that I grow. Next bed is kind of like a mixed bed. We have some kind of like bok choys growing in here. And then we have some cabbages. And I think there's a beet there and more cabbage. And then in the middle, we have more kind of cover type crops. They're, peas. So they're nitrogen fixing as well as producing, you could actually eat the shoots. And actually, I think this variety is a Chinese variety that's actually grown just for the tips. So these peas actually are grown for just actually the greens. I don't know what kind of peas actually they're gonna make, but all the other ones actually are either a snow pea or a sugar pod pea that has the edible shell. So we did that for cover cropping, and it's, you know, one of my favorite kind of like beans actually to eat. I don't eat a whole lot of beans or peas. Next on the end here, we have some parsley that's still going from the summertime and a whole bunch of other mixed greens on this side. This next bed, we've kind of duplicated the same thing as the previous bed. Once again, in the wintertime, the greens don't grow quite as fast. So I found that you really need to plant a lot more. We got the early start on this bed here because we started that early, but all these ones are still not quite in their prime. They're not quite growing as fast. Once they get to the stage over here, then they grow much, much faster because, you know, there's just more leaf surface area to get sun and grow faster. We did transplant some celery over in this bed that was in the front bed. Looks like it still is growing pretty good. And once again, we have the peas in the middle. Help fix nitrogen and make some food here in a couple months. And some escarole and some herbs here on this end that was left over from summertime. And let's see, the next bed here, we have the definitely the pea bed. This is where all the cucumbers were last year with our set trellises in place. We're probably gonna do cucumbers again here next year in the summertime. So we want to nitrogen fix. So once again, we got the peas here growing. But also in between, we planted carrots and you could see the greens coming up. So we're gonna try to make space of every possible, make space of every possible space to plant. So we planted the carrots, fairly close because they can be close. We're using the square foot gardening methods. I mean, that's literally, 4 inches, 3 or 4 inches apart right there. And this whole bed is basically peas. And actually it's doing quite well compared to some of the other peas, but we did plant this out earlier. Last bit, of course, has the tree kale. And we did cuttings of the tree kale. Maybe I'll have another episode on that. And we're going to basically next summer, we're going to have this bed filled with tree kale. Meanwhile, we have some of the Jersey kale in here, walking stick kale, and some other greens growing. I think I see some spinach down there, just other mixed greens in the bottom. Over this bed underneath the overhang, we planted this out fairly early. Some of the things did pretty well and some things didn't. Have some of the kales. Some variegated sorrel, which is a really cool plant. Doesn't taste too good, but it is edible. And escaroles and things like that. Doing fairly well. The lettuce didn't do too well back over here, and the celery's finally headed up, and it's probably almost time to harvest it. It looks like it's almost separating. And right by the door, I planted a whole bunch of cilantro since I love cilantro, and I wanted it to keep a little bit, stay a little bit warmer. And finally, this bed over here is just basically, once again, mixed greens and the trees. And also we have all the dino kale from the summertime still growing. And now it's like they're actually doing really well. I was noticing like the leaves are really kicking out new leaves, new growth, and nice large, pretty leaves. All right, so this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Hope you've learned something and what you can plant right now in Northern California and other, you know, moderate climates here. And I hope I've encouraged you to, you know, start growing your own food.